Resembling, come on, beat ya. I'll always be right back here to meet ya. I know you're
my sure hope that wasn't playing that song the whole time. Oh, really? There we go. Furthermore, the desert must be found. Thank you.
We'll be right back. you're super quiet. Let me check a thing. Yeah, you should be coming through on the headset.
Okay, I'm being picked up by this. Furthermore, the desert must also be crossed.
You're really popping. Is your microphone up? So quiet is because you're not actually coming through on the stream. I know you're saying stuff, but I'm not hearing them. Check your microphone, make sure the cord's okay.
Test?
Test.
Yes!
Huzzah!
So, testers about to graduate, like, in 2 days. So they did my final today.
Would it happen to be you?
Yes.
I
am almost done with school, can you believe it? Well, actually, and technically I am done with school, because I'm about to graduate.
Where are you going to college?
I'll get back to you on that, but the plan is for me to have, like, a year where I'm just working, and then go to Wake Tech as a transition period, and then go to NC State University.
That is a good plan. Work experience will do good.
Yeah. I'm trying to get a job at GameStop, so I can, because, you know, that...
Yeah.
Hey,
is
a dog holding a knife? Yeah.
Oh, hey, the infamous 1,000 needles attack.
That'll be fun to look at. Also, I set a reservation for Kirby Planet Robobot when it comes out at a GameStop near me. So, basically, this will be my first day one purchase in game.
Awesome. You know, Shaq's...
Yeah, the earliest I've ever gotten a game.
You know Shag's planning on doing a blind run ahead, right?
So am I. And I'm not just gonna do the main game, I'm gonna do the hard mode, I'm gonna do the sub games, I'm gonna do both arenas.
You're gonna do everything.
Yeah. I don't know if I'll go for all of the... whatever the main collectible is, though. Ow! That hurt.
Well, it's 1,000 needles.
Yeah. If I do end up going for all the, I'm gonna say sunstones, just giving everyone an idea of what kind of collectible I'm talking about. I may follow a guide for that after I beat the main game. But yeah, I'm glad that the two mini games are actually more. Fun than DDD's Drum Dash. I'm terrible at that sub game. I'm terrible. It's a neat concept, but I'm terrible at it. So, yeah. I'm interested in Team Kirby Clash, and Kirby 3D Rumble is. I am very excited to try that out, because it seems like a test for 3D Kirby games to come. And if that is true, that'll be awesome!
Oh, hey, a cutscene that I probably could have found a couple weeks ago and didn't.
Also, recently I found Kirby and Sonic 2, which is not just a sprite hack, not a simple sprite hack. It also changes the life system to a health system. You, unless you're set on beginner mode, you don't lose rings when you hit, and when it beats for every 50 rings you collect, you get an extra life, which is your health. Basically, when you get hit, you instead lose a life as opposed to losing your rings, but you don't reset in the, but you don't reset the stage unless it's a death by smashing or bottomless pit.
Ah, yeah.
And star posts also give you extra hits to survive.
That sounds interesting. I'll have to try that one.
Yeah.
How's it handle?
Well, Kirby has his inhale attack, which can inhale enemies and items. Items are also reportedly random, so there are some bad items you can come across. So be warned of that. Now, this can be changed by setting the game to easy or beginner, but normal mode and the hardest mode have random items, which isn't too bad a deal once you get used to it. But yeah, and so Kirby has his inhale, also an instant run ability, which sends him to a pretty fast speed from a standstill, but done by doing a peel-out motion. And he also has a float jump, which is basically a double jump that leaves him vulnerable, but a double jump in a Sonic game, much less a classic Sonic game. Do I even need to explain how that's useful?
Well, have you ever tried Sonic 1 Mega Mix?
No, I haven't.
It's got a double jump in it.
Well, yeah. But I'd imagine that game would be built around a double jump. But, like, well, they would have obstacles built around a double jump, but in a classic Sonic game like Sonic 2, yeah. Also, you can also play as Waddle Dee, who has all of Kirby's abilities except the inhale and float jump. But he has the instant run, at least. And of course, they can roll. They can't spin dash, but they can roll. Because they have the run. And you can just start a run and press down immediately to spin. It's a technical hyper instant spin dash, but so it goes. Yeah, it's very fun. I will warn you, though. Silver Sonic has a lot more health, I think, to make sure people can see the spike and launch attack, because he takes more than 8 hits to defeat, and I want to say even the final boss has a few extra hit points, but no, all the rest of the bosses still have 8. Oh, and Hidden Palace Zone is restored in Mystic Cave Act 2, but you skip Sky Chase Zone. So yeah.
Apparently now we're flying.
Yay! Speak of the devil, I just mentioned Sky Chase Zone. Lo and behold, we're flying. You know, I haven't yet beaten Mystic Cave. I'm gonna... No, not Mystic Cave, in Palace Zone. And I want to say that it's a ported version of the one from Sonic 2 2015. Maybe. It doesn't look like Proto Palace.
Dang it.
Oh hey, so how do I host you again?
Type dot host and then whoever you're trying to host.
Okay, I might as well host you on my channel since I do not have permission to perform the accent.
You have to do it from your channel's channel.
Ah. Well, I was saying I might as well do that since I'm not streaming, and since I'm on your stream. You know?
Sorcerer's one more. Ah.
And I can spell your name perfectly. Two host commands remaining this half hour.
Yeah, you get 3 for 3.
Raikou.
Raikou? Yeah.
That's how it's pronounced. So yeah, I'm hosting you now. So when when it said Melrose was hosting me, that's what it meant. Huh. Yep. He's crazy!
Carbuncle,
Kerberos. Okay, so 19, 65, 9, 7. And let's go to Mystic Cave Act 2 just so I can fall into the pit and see if that's where the hidden palace is. Because Hidden Palace in this hack is still hidden, like in Sonic 2013, you don't go straight to it. But there's only one act. So that makes me wonder if it's the same. Ow. Maybe it is a finished version of Royal Palace.
A whole bunch of Thundagas. Hello, Sanderson Smithsonian.
Ow, okay. So yeah, if you want to get into Kirby in Sonic 2, but you don't want to get used to the random items or the life health system, you can set the beginner mode for a transition period.
Okay.
Still,
I can tell it's been
amazing.
A few weeks since I played this.
Yeah, just a bit. You can't those are Siberian Huskies, oh my gosh. I love Siberian Huskies. They're my favorite.
Listen, you're not carrying any magic.
They're my favorite dog breed. I want to get one on Nintendogs, but I don't have enough trainer points yet.
No. I junctioned them to Renoa. By complete accident.
Okay. Boom, boom, ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum. Ow!
Hello!
Are you actually streaming, or are you...
I am actually streaming.
Okay, let's see if the pit is a path. Okay, it is a path to Hidden Palace. Nice!
Final Fantasy again?
Yeah, we're back on Final Fantasy this week.
I'm playing Kirby and Sonic 2, and hosting him on my Twitch channel. And this version of Hidden Palace has, not the Mystic Cave 2-player music, but, the actual Hidden Palace music.
And my Merc is beeping at me. Apparently someone just resubscribed to, Family Jewels.
Family Jewels?
He's a musician on YouTube who streams some of his stuff.
How do I get past this? Cause Kirby cannot spin dash. Ah, okay. Momentum!
What were you trying to get past?
Curve and... Kirby's instant run is good, but it's not as fast as a fully charged spin dash, which can lead to some issues. I don't even think it's as fast as a non-fully charged spin dash, so it's not too bad of an issue, but you do need to...
break.
You will gain momentum at certain points.
Break?
What is a Buzz Bomber doing here? Well, not a Buzz Bomber, but the B enemies in Sonic. I fell!
Break.
Did I really just fall backwards through the level? I think I did.
No, really. Thank
I
you.
Did.
Break. Thank you for that.
Oh dear. Lost my barrier. So even though you have a health life system, if you get hit with when you have a barrier, you still only lose the barrier instead of the life.
What the heck are you playing?
He is
Kirby
playing
and Sonic 2.
Yeah, he's playing a ROM hack.
It's actually I don't blame any ROM hacks, and I gotta say, I really like this one. Ow. Okay, thank goodness the spike bug is not in this game. Okay.
Well, I should hope it's not in
this game. Okay.
It was removed from Sonic 2.
Well, yeah, but... Okay, let's go back to Hidden Palace. After that spiel of why did that happen. A detail such as removing the pit and adding Hidden Palace in, it just says Kirby in Sonic 2, but it's neat that they did something like that. Okay, those enemies cannot be in the hand.
Ooh, stop.
Oh wait, they actually can. Their AI just doesn't agree with it at times. Oops. This is the kind of ROM hack that, dare I say it, I would actually tell in you to erase to Dakota. Just because it's that fun. Well, what hit me? Okay,
Buzz Bomber.
That... No, it was some kind of Rex, and now I got hit by a bat. I am not familiar with Hidden Palace. Much less with Kirby, of all things. I like the idea of Hidden Palace actually being hidden, though. Yeah, I want to say this hack was made rather recently, but I don't quote me on that. What I do know, though, is that it's very fun. Because I'm a huge Sonic fan, I'm a huge Kirby fan, and there's also one for Sonic 1, but not Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Ow! You stop that, bat. For a second I thought that was a dramatic kiss scene between Rinoa and...
Squall.
Cloud.
It almost was, but they had to escape.
Okay, Buzz Bomber, I broke Buzz Bomber's AI to where it's rocketing all over the place. Yeah, that Buzz Bomber is just doomed to wreck time and space for all eternity.
As an expert cloud observer, they're flying in this line. I'm gonna let it sit on this line for a bit.
I got a Robotnik and a Waddle Dee, which is useful if your Waddle Dee gets an extra life. But it's not that useful if you're playing as Kirby, because for some reason they decided to include Waddle Dee's icon in the random thing. And that doesn't give Kirby an extra life. Quite the opposite. Not the opposite. It doesn't take a life from him. That's what Robotnik's for, but you get the idea. Whee! Ow.
Let's go head to Adana's house. So now we go back to where I started this week from.
Oh, you're going back to the giant ship?
We're going back to Adana's house, that's where I had saved last time.
Okay, that's the end. Okay, so that's the end of Hidden Palace. It doesn't go to the boss. It ends on it. Maybe this is a different Hidden Palace than the one from the 2013 game. And it leads straight to Oil Ocean. You can skip the boss of Mystic Cave. Ow.
If it's a ROM hack, they probably went on the, they probably went with the quote-unquote restored version from 2006, I think.
2006? What?
Yeah, there was, like, a beta or something released of Sonic the Hedgehog, only it wasn't really a beta, it was just someone pretending it was a beta.
I don't know, it didn't look like Proto Palace. And it was only one act. It looked like a different layout for Hidden Palace than I had seen before.
Of course it kills Quistus.
Yeah, I think you'll have to play and see for yourself, because...
I think I know what you're talking about, though. Did you have to break a giant emerald-looking thing to get anywhere?
Actually, no. I did not. No, there was no giant emerald, it was removed. But I know what you're talking about when you say giant emerald. It was the old master emerald before that was changed to a plot point and not a breakable object.
Right.
Just think, if that really was the master emerald, Knuckles would be pissed. Mad.
He would be very disappointed.
Yeah. And, I just said that word. Okay. Whoops.
Oh, don't tell me I need to have Renova in the party for this. Where the hell am I coming?
I gotta continue in Hidden Palace? Really? Also, Pakoda, I've noticed during your races, you don't spin dash at the beginning of the stage.
I have not trained myself to do that.
We need to work on your basic speedrunning skills, even if you're not speedrunning. Because, yeah. Spin dashing at the beginning of a stage should be pretty much a given in a race. No offense, but yeah. With the exception being Sonic 1, because I don't feel like I need to explain that one.
Yeah, there's no spin dash. Well, I'm here at Adana's house, game. Where do I go next?
Playing as Kirby in Sonic 2 and in Oil Ocean. It's just weird. I'm playing as Kirby in Sonic 2, and it works.
I think that's the part that's scariest. It works.
What?
I think that's the part that's scariest, is that it works.
Yeah, it's... You don't get copy abilities from inhaling enemies, rather, it's basically inhaling it and activates spin dash charging mode for Curry, and that it activates an active hitbox that you can even hit Silver Sonic with if you hold it. Like four hits at the beginning, just like you can do with a standard charge spin dash. And it sucks in enemies with a magnetic, with like the way that other things attract, that the magnet shield in Sonic 3 attracts rings. And they don't just head straight for Kirby, they like swirl around too. And of course you have a dash, like I said, which is actually very fun to use.
So if I could, unfortunately, turn our attention away from Sonic for a second.
Sorry.
Did you know the 3DO had games?
Yeah.
Because... Oh, you actually did?
Yeah.
You might have been one of the people I told about, it, actually.
No. Because
I discovered the 3DO has, like, a bunch of fucking games. And people were like, oh, you found a 3DO game player ROM thing. I'm guessing all it plays is Plumber Don't Have Ties, and I'd actually get to say no. It plays other things.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The 3DO.
The 3DO is a very odd system.
3DO.
The best way I can describe it is think of a Sega CD if it was a multimedia player.
The main reason I know 3DO is because of the Might and Magic series. They took New World Computing under their wing when NWC started to go under, and 3DO handled the Windows series against 6-9. And I think they also handled publishing for the Heroes series up until Heroes 5.
Okay. You realize you're gonna have to show me later what that actually is, because it's kind of hard to visualize.
Yes, what's a little baby?
A what?
A little baby. He's a little baby. He's the youngest.
How young am I compared to you guys?
Well, I'm 26.
I'm 18. I still have to wonder how I ended up liking games like Kirby and Sonic, but not liking games like Call of Duty and such, given the generation I was born into. I guess I was really lucky. Ow. Oh, the RNG could never be more trollish than that.
Yep, this can't be good.
What happened?
Plot.
Plot.
Kiros. Oh wow, that's a name I haven't seen in weeks.
Curious. Okay. Yeah, Waddle Dee doesn't have the inhale or the hover jump. He only has an old jump and a run. So basically, he's Kirby with less abilities. He he's less fun unless you want a challenge. Frankly, I just like Kirby more in this game. Yeah. Oh man, imagine Meta Knight in Sonic 2. He'd just be flying everywhere, and I don't even know how his gameplay would work, but it sure as heck wouldn't be. I don't know. Frankly, I have no idea how his gameplay would work.
Oh look, you're in spaceship now. When did you get that?
But yeah, one challenge.
About 20 minutes into the stream, when I finally finished crossing the desert.
You beat the thing in the desert?
No, what happened was a couple weeks ago, last time I played, I crossed the desert thinking I had to go back to the orphanage. When it turns out all I had to do was go back into the ship.
I don't... Well, I'm not Waddle Dee. That will not give me an extra life. Do not keep giving me Waddle Dee icons. And
I'm sorry, I'm still in shock from that.
What?
The thing where you basically just has to fuck off back into the ship. I'm amazed that that was an actual thing. Also, why don't the Wall-D icons give you one up? They probably should, if you're Wall-D.
There's a Kirby icon, which gives you a one up, and by the way, one up, your lives are basically your health in this game, unless you set it to beginner mode. So basically, if you get hit, you don't lose your rings, but you lose a life, and the game.
Wait, did he say Estar or Galbadia?
What?
Of course he said Estar. I'm not trying to go to Galbadia.
But Waddle Dee icons can also appear, and if you're playing as Waddle Dee, that gives you an extra life, but as Kirby,
not so
and
much.
I'd imagine vice versa.
Oh, so you can also use the power-up to switch in between the two.
Ow.
It doesn't sound like that. It sounds more like the box just exists to give one-ups.
No, it's like if you get a Tails box as Sonic in 2-player mode,
oh,
it gives Tails the 1-up, but since Waddle Dee isn't present, it just acts as it makes an error sound. And since the boxes are random, it's not like you'll tell what you get. And also Robotnik can appear, so which costs you one of your lives if you're not holding a shield or invincible.
Oh my god, that city graphic like before the fight, that was beautiful. I didn't even know that was supposed to be a city on the first glance, I just guessed. If it's not a city, I will be extremely disappointed, Bakuda.
It is the city of Estar.
Oh, I was right.
Really, Zell, you punched yourself?
Hold on, I'm catching up to the stream, I have to see this. Okay, that's funny. That was pretty funny.
No, this is not a game. I don't want to open Game Bar. I don't want to open Game Bar, game! Or computer.
Do I not have any antidotes? I have tanks.
Cloud is covered in bubbles, and Renoa has some kind of greenish, bubblish aura above her head.
Poison.
Oh.
Great, poison.
Yay!
That just rained from these things.
So yeah, this game has more of an emphasis on making sure you don't get hit over speed. And you want to make sure you have a lot of lives for when you get the death egg.
So, takes away the main gameplay feature of Sonic, the thing that makes Sonic so good.
Well, you can still turn on beginner mode and lives and rings function as they do in normal Sonic games, but
don't know where I'm going anymore.
I was hoping it would just be Sonic. It would be Kirby and a Sonic hat. That probably would have been pretty funny, although the joke would probably get old really fast.
You mean Kirby and a Sonic hat as a simple sprite hack?
Yeah.
Yeah,
but like how they would do it in Smash Bros.
Yeah, but it's still nice. He has an instant run, like I said. And I want to say they even fixed some sequence breaks that are very popular to do.
Wow, your party got murdered.
What happened?
My party got murdered.
Cloud and Runoa basically got killed. Zell somehow survived.
Get them before the party arrived.
Well, Zell managed to run away very fast.
Zell managed to not get hit.
Wait a sec. I swear there seems to be some changed level designs in this hack. Some slightly changed level designs.
Examples, please.
Like, it seemed like there was one spot that didn't have there's ground underneath your feet, but it didn't seem like there was ground there before. In Chemical Plant too. Like, prevent you from falling down back down to the other path or something. Robotnik. Waddle Dee. I'm outrunning the screen with Kirby, kind of.
Gotta go fast, right?
Yeah! Okay, so I got two barriers and then an Eggman, so basically that changes on us. I want to say Kirby has an inherent smaller hitbox than Sonic and Tails, just with his standing, but I'm not sure. Maybe smaller, because it seems like he can collect some rings above his head. So maybe his hitbox is the same for collecting rings and such, but
I took
smaller.
One step.
Oh my gosh. It's gotten to that, has it? That's saddening.
Oh god, that looks dangerous.
That was an Eggman. Why was it an Eggman? Yay, rings! Well, Waddle Dee is at least better than Eggman in that I don't get hurt. Damn it. Go ahead and add two more rings for an extra life. I'm at 10 lives, and since lives are health, that at least means I can take 10 hits before dying.
Pain. I received two pains.
Two pains?
Two pains.
So I told someone who is a fanatic of Amy and Sonic 2 that I'll be playing Sonic 2 Pink Edition on stream on Sunday, and well, technically I will.
Who did you tell, WST?
You know him?
They're on Task Videos.
Oh, yeah, that's the person I told. I actually will still play it on Super Edition and Scream, but I want to play a bit of a joke on that. Because, yeah. I don't usually get a chance to do play practical jokes, so I decided I might as well.
Well, it's a good thing that WSD doesn't watch my streams, huh?
Yeah.
I wonder what this pain spell does.
Well, technically what I'm playing right now is Sonic 2 Pink Edition. Now we just need the Pink Kitty Rose version. Hey, if that becomes a thing, let me know. Because I'd play that.
Well, you know how she is with challenge runs, right?
Okay. Yeah, that would be fun. Hey, you know how I am with challenge runs, too.
This is true.
I may be as insane, if not more, than Pink when it comes to the challenge runs.
That's gonna happen.
Except I will not do Mega Man no damage because I'm not the best at Mega Man, so I know my limits at least.
You should play Make a Good Mega Man level contest.
The Mad Mike?
I do like Mega Man, but it's not one of the series I'm best at.
Level 5 death.
Also, it's the most disheartening thing ever to find out your level doesn't actually work. I don't know what happened to my level. I need to find you a video of it after this.
What happened? Wait,
but
what are you talking about?
What happened is, are you any of you familiar with Mario Maker? Because I'm actually going to make a quote from
something. I have Mario Maker.
There used to be a glitch with, like, invisible blocks. I have to actually find the judge's comment.
Oh my gosh! I have found the ultimate! Kirby's float breaks the slot machine. And by that I mean you can just keep on hopping back in when you fall out.
That's because Kirby was never meant for a slot machine environment.
And that is why you don't put a double jump in Sonic 2.
Especially one that refreshes after slot machine. I didn't think it refreshed after the slot machine.
Okay, we're finally in the city.
In the proper city. Found it.
Okay. Yep. Time to cheese! I don't care, Robotnik. I can just keep getting me back in.
Okay, yep. Here's how one of the judges described my level. I'm not quite sure how to describe this, but it kind of works like a therapy for me. Occasionally, I look at some old Mario Maker levels and get sad because Nintendo patched out the glitch that allows you to have invisible blocks and blocks that behave like other blocks.
I remember reading that. What happened?
I load up this level and spend a few minutes on it, and suddenly I respect their decision. Oh yeah, Pyro's comment was the best one. I'm posting this in Streamhouse.
Ah, Robotnik!
That was Pyro's comment. I kid you not. Just that picture. And you wanna know what? I didn't even get last place! Someone beat me. Fucking Nolan.
I remember seeing his level and thinking, okay, what?
Although I think it's Pyro's least favorite level.
Yeah.
Goofy. Wow.
I check out all the judges' least favorite levels. I actually have a story of why I didn't actually make an extreme, like a pretty decent level that I'd originally planned, and that's because fucking computer classes that are like 5 weeks and just say, here's a bunch of homework, but I have other classes. No, keep having homework.
That's like college
five-week. It was like a 5 week class. It got to the point of absurdity. Because these things would take like over an hour to do, and they were fucking Excel exercises.
Well, here's the thing. Stuff like that,
they just took
stuff like that, they expect you to be doing 40 hours a week between the classes themselves and the homework. They expect you to be putting in 40 hours a week. And it makes it really hard to do both work and school at the same time.
At least the red ring item, which takes away your rings, and of course it's from the random items, doesn't matter much other than making it so that you lose your ring, lose some of your rings, and since you don't lose rings when hit, as you have a different health system when the red rings appear, that's okay.
Yeah, but they expect you to do 40. Yeah, they expect me to do. I think originally her plan was I do two chapters in a single fucking week.
Oh my gosh.
I have a programming course. I can't do that shit.
Wait, I have to do like two chapters sometimes at on 1984. So I
no, this is probably kind of worse because Excel program Excel
is a pain.
Are pains, yeah. And originally her plan was you had to do 6 assignments in about a week.
Okay.
Yes,
you reduced it to 3 after I think we complained about it. I don't remember how that happened. I missed 3 assignments in that class somehow, but I did really well. Not well enough to pass, mind you, but.
Oh.
I will bet you anything I got really close to passing that class. The thing is, she would basically, instead of saying, you guys could do the tutorial with me, she said, you guys get to watch a tutorial. You get to watch me do the tutorial, and you can't do the tutorial on your own. You have to do it on your own. You can't do it in class.
That's the worst.
I hated that class. I had a lot of problems with it. So did a lot of other people. I mean, if we were able to do the tutorials in class, I think the effect might have been lessened. So that we'd only get like 2 assignments, which wouldn't be that bad, actually.
I don't know where I'm going anymore. Again. More this time.
Yeah, this.
Oh, did you?
This could potentially be taxed.
Which one?
Sonic Kirby and Sonic 2. Because it's different enough that it could warrant taxed. Could be interesting.
Mechanically, you're right. It's just I don't see there being much of an audience for it. I would say post it to the Sonic 2 thread before doing anything else with it. See if there's anyone interested in watching a task of it. It's probably not going to be published.
It's more than just a sprite hack, so I think, and it's, because it's a huge change, I think it has a chance. What with Kirby's instant run and everything.
Well, a large part of the reason why I don't think it would get published is because it doesn't change the stages. So it's
doesn't change
the stages significantly. So it would just—it would be another character hack along the line of Knuckles in Sonic 1, Tails in Sonic 1, Amy in Sonic 3.5. We've already got a bunch of them on the public.
Well, Amy in Sonic 3 wasn't accepted.
That's because it was Amy.
And this is Kirby.
Kirby's not a Sonic character, is the problem.
But he's still a popular character. And I think it has a chance, myself. If you were to ask me, I'd say it has a chance.
What
did that imp just cast Holy on me?
Probably. Whenever I hear about cats doing dickish things, I can't help but think, cats might actually be evil. Like, I don't know if you were there when Ziggurat was, I was talking to Ziggurat about his cat problem, but something came up with Photos, and, one of his cats killed things, which I know cats do, but, like, if you look at that mini conversation in general.
I'm sorry, I'm doing terrible at this boss. Gotten hit, like, 3 times. Now,
and or Noah's day.
No, not Manoa.
Pop a bunch of songs. I'm going to be so happy when I finally get all the reflect.
You're gonna be so fine when you have what?
Auto-reflect.
Oh, that sounds like it'll be fun.
It's going to be very helpful.
Okay! I just basically activated one of the most epic glitches ever. And that is the inhale ability while you're moving. Like, the effect of the inhale while you're moving. It cancels out when you're hit or after you finish another inhale.
Please tell me you're recording input.
Not yet, but it's something that's easy to replicate. It's easier to abuse in Metropolis instead of Hilltop, where, because in Hilltop you can do it off the seesaws, but it ends when you land unless you still hold it. Like the normal spin dash.
This thing is kicking my ass and I can't run. When was the last time I saved?
That's the question. You, how many times have you asked that question now, Dakota?
Today, just once.
In general?
I don't know anymore. Oh good, that's enough for Renzo. Question is, will I live long enough to pull it off? That would be a no. Okay. Living in the city works a lot better when I survive. All the way over here, okay.
I haven't been on Skype House in a while. I figured I'd go catch up with them.
Skype Pod?
Yeah, Skype House, as in we actually have a
Skype group,
which is called Skype House. Get how the house thing started, and yes, it's pronounced H-A-U-S.
Yeah, I was wondering about that.
I don't know why. I've never actually asked. Despite the many changes of names, I just keep calling it Skype house, or in this case for the Discord, I call it Discord house 2, because there's
there's this one, and then there's the one that Apostle is part of.
Which most of the people don't want anything to do with him. And he's been burned so bad, he doesn't want anything to do with them either. First, they see him as the villain.
Yeah, that's about right.
Oh my god.
It's basically that a case of that. Everybody hates everybody else.
Yeah.
Wee.
And I understand how it's
something like that.
And I understand how it started. It's just I wish that everyone would just let it go.
Shut up and get along.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unfortunately, people hold grudges.
Yep. Grudges are a thing.
I talked to Apostate too, which I will probably never admit in Discord house. I've talked to him before. He's a pretty decent guy. And I think Photos has talked to him like once or twice. Because me and I think a few, like one or two other people in the Discord house are actually a part of ISO's community. In case you don't know, ISO is another Let's Player. He plays almost the same things Ralka does, but he does some different things.
Oh, hey, those things are immune to ground because they're flying. Okay, that's good to know.
Pay attention to Pokemon, man. This is something that you might have guessed.
Well, I wasn't throwing around the summons before, so I didn't have a chance to know.
Boom, 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 boom.
And even then, and we still have people in Skype House who refuse to switch you over.
Because they know a post case or
like, for example, Pichu.
Playing Rock, Paper, Scissors.
2.0. Pichu absolutely hates Skype. It absolutely hates Discord, from what I've heard. And I don't think, I don't remember his name, but he's Omedo Bear. He doesn't want to switch. And I think that's because, what was it? Someone else wouldn't switch. Basically. I know 128 ups in Skype has 2.0 under a very weird name. So is. Actually, I don't think Heavy Sigh is here either. There's quite a few people who, probably won't ever switch until Skype basically becomes unbearable to use. Which might actually happen.
Well, I've more or less abandoned Skype because Discord is so much less resource intensive. And it's not accurate.
Yeah.
I will say that's one of the reasons why I really like it. It's kind of like TeamSpeak, but I feel like TeamSpeak has more organization. This is good for, Discord's good for, like, smaller groups.
Well,
it's also good for, like, text chats, so.
Well, if you've ever used Ventrilo, this is a lot like Ventrilo. Only it's got the text chat as well.
I've probably used it, like, only a few times. Like, I actually have a story. The only time I use Ventrilo is because one of my, a long time ago, I think this is back in 2014, I ran a Shadowrun group, and one of the guys said, oh, I can offer up Ventrilo since a few of our players don't want to use Skype. So basically, I ran the Shadowrun using that in Roll20. Although I'm more familiar with, Discord, Skype, and TeamSpeak.
I think I tried using TeamSpeak exactly once. And it was just
That's the thing that's a virus, isn't it?
No.
Where it makes it very easy to...
No, you're thinking of... I think you're thinking of TeamViewer?
Yeah, I think it's that.
Yeah, I've never used TeamViewer. I don't like any of those... Here, I'll give you access to my desktop remotely things.
Yeah.
One of the reason why I've never used Hamachi for.
You know, they don't gain access to your.
Well, Hamachi is
desktop.
I've used Tamachi before. It's not...
Oh god, it's this scene!
Yeah, it's this scene.
It's this scene! Oh, I thought this was the scene where... I'm thinking of another game, aren't I?
I'm not sure. What game are you thinking of?
Well, there was this one Final Fantasy game, spoiler alert, you might want to turn off now, where basically the villain just stabs one of the main girls. Don't remember. I think it was Renoa that basically gets stabbed by the main villain, Sephiroth or something.
Oh, you're talking about Seven!
Seven. Thank you.
Yeah, Seven is actually on my list of Final Fantasies to stream, but that one's not going to be blind. I've played Seven. Actually, my current run of Seven is stalled because I forgot that the Materia Keeper is immune to fire, and I keep trying to use Vincent's Limit Break. Which, that's not going to work.
Since I have never played a Final Fantasy game, I have no idea why that wouldn't work. Because I don't know what it is, or... I know what Sephiroth and Cloud are, but...
Long story short, the Materia Keeper is immune to fire, to electric, and to ice, and I believe it actually absorbs them, which is why bringing Vincent and having him use his Limit Breaks is counterproductive. Because as much damage as I can dish out with Cloud and whoever else I had packed along, Vincent was just restoring it. And it is a forced fight, so I have to find some way to beat it. The fact that see you later, Sanderson. The fact that I have to deal with the Materia Keeper has kind of been why I haven't been playing it lately. Oh, hi there, Lunatic Pandora. You're in the way.
I literally can't see this chat, and I have no idea what's going on.
What it is I have Merc configured to show me when people join and leave my stream chat.
Oh.
That's why I can... That's why when I have it up, I can say, hi there, person!
Yeah. I don't know how it works either.
Okay, let's do this scene again.
Oil Ocean has always been my favorite stage in Sonic 2, and in pretty much the entire series. I don't know why it's that.
Thank you, Quistus.
Coda, what exactly is your favorite stage in Sonic 2? Or by extension, the series?
Sonic 2 specifically?
Oh, I probably should have expected that.
Series as a whole? Never thought about that. Probably Ice Cap.
Really?
Yeah.
I was not expecting that. Wow. Have you ever played any of the advanced games?
I've played 1 and 2. I've beaten 1, I've not beaten 2.
I've played and beaten 1 and 2. I've played 3. I realized I did a boss rush once, but I had to use cheats to actually get to the end of the game, so I have not legitimately beaten that. Mainly, when I did those boss rushes, I'll admit, I used cheats to simply get all access to all the bosses. So that I could easily get access to them without having to play through the entire game first. Because bosses were what I was most interested in the games. So I still have yet to actually beat 3. It's hard. Currently Advanced 1 is the only one I'm actually best at, and I suck at 2. I should be better at 2, but I suck at 2. And mainly because of the stages and the bosses when I fight them without cream.
Well, one of the things I want to do is start doing flute covers of songs from video games, and one of the songs that I want to cover is Launch Base Zone from Advance 1.
launch base from Advanced. What, you mean Egg Rocket Zone?
Yeah, that. Where you're going up the rocket.
Mm-hmm. I was surprised when I found out that was actually a thing, and that there was actually an Egg Rocket Zone. I thought I came up with it. But, so I guess. Let's see. Time to play as Cream in Sonic 2, because Cream.
Sonic 2 Advanced or Sonic 2?
Sonic 2.
Ah.
Pink Edition. Not that pink.
Sonic
or
2.
Or the other pink that was just playing.
Sonic 2 Cheese Edition.
Yeah. Yeah, in multiple senses of the word.
Well, be glad you're not playing Sonic 2 Giant Cherry Edition.
Giant what edition?
Giant Cherry Edition.
What's that supposed to be? I'm not sure I understand.
Apples do not fall up. Well, they're more like giant cherries.
Oh yeah, Cream can fly in this game.
Okay, so
she
we are
going to... She has a sound when she tires out. Special sound. Maybe I should join the Advanced 2 race in Sonic Speed R. Just because I know I'm gonna lose. Oh, we should check the schedule again, because, you know, Sonic 2 is on there.
Yeah, I believe Sonic 2 is on a Friday?
Yeah, and I believe Sonic CD is... Hang on, let me pull up the schedule. Sonic Speed R. Sonic Speed R.
I think my best time on Sonic CD is an hour. I'd have to take a look at that stream archive. Seriously.
Yeah, I remember you streamed it once.
Or that wasn't a stream that I did Sonic CD 2. That I just recorded that one out of the blue. That one was never streamed.
It's weird being able to fly in Sonic 2.
Gee, you think?
Yeah, just a bit. And can't Tails fly in the remake?
I don't know, I don't have the remake.
I believe he actually can, just to distance some his gameplay from Sonic, and that really breaks the Wing Fortress boss.
Bet I can land it here. Ah! That's what I thought, I could land at the air station. Now here's hoping I find a save point before I get massacred.
Okay, so... this Saturday... I don't know the exact time, but this Saturday, Sonic CD is happening.
Ah.
Today, Sonic 1 8-bit is happening, and tomorrow, Sonic Heroes is happening.
Oh crap, that was this week? I thought that wasn't for another week.
This Saturday is Sonic CD.
Well, no, I mean
that one.
No, I mean the races in general. I didn't think the whole thing started until Monday.
Yesterday was Sonic Generations. Oh, okay. So each day there will be two races. One held at 8 p.m. Central European Daylight Time, and another held at 8 p.m. American Eastern Daylight Time. You may only have one race per day count towards the result, and it must be the first race you race in. The point in having multiple races is for time zones, not meters.
Yeah, that makes sense. But
so,
I thought
yeah.
That was next week, not this week.
It's all throughout the month.
Oh, okay.
So on Saturday is Sonic CD. I'm gonna name the ones that we might wanna pay attention to. On Saturday, June 7th is Sonic Advance 2. June 10th, a Friday, is Sonic Advance. June 11th, a Saturday, is Sonic Adventure DX. June 12th is Sonic 3 and Knuckles. June 16th is Sonic Rush, which I will be running, definitely. 17th. June 18th is Sonic 2. And June 19th is Sonic Adventure 2 Battle. I'll participate in that because I know I'm going to lose. June 20th is Sonic 4 Episode 1. June 22nd is Sonic 4 Episode 2. June 23rd is Sonic 1. June 24th is Sonic R. And June 25th is the mystery game we'll want to keep our eyes on. Wait. No, I got that wrong. June 22nd is Sonic 4 Episode 2. June 23rd is Sonic 1. June 24th is Sonic R.
Kyros and Ward. And the man with the machine gun.
20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Okay, this is a typo. I'm saying... On the final Saturday of the month is the mystery game.
So I'm going to admit this now. I have had this relationship spoiled for me. I've been wondering when this would come up.
What?
You're about to find out.
Well, it's buffering. I should refresh.
Don't refresh the whole page. Just pause the stream and I'll
too late. Up.
Oh, hello. Look, suddenly I'm the only person here.
Hello, Laguna.
So I'll tell you where I am when the stream continues. Well, currently I'm in an Overwatch app. App. Yes.
Let me know when you close the app.
Did you say app or ad?
App.
Closing the ad. There.
Okay.
It just pulled up where I said, I'll tell you where I am when the stream loads. So I think I missed it.
Well, let's start from the bottom and work our way up. What are you doing here, Dad?
What?
Laguna is Squall's dad.
Okay, that's gotta be awkward.
They haven't revealed this yet.
Oh.
I have no words. So, they went back in time?
Long story short, Eleni had been sending Squall and Zell, and I think it was Quistis, back in time to help out Laguna and his group. But Eleni can only send people back into people that she knows. The final villain of this game wants to use Eleni's power, and I'm not entirely sure how that would work. But if Ultimecia got a hold of Eleni's abilities, Ultimecia would be the only living thing left.
Well, that's not good.
That's why we're trying to stop it.
Isn't this game the one with Triple Triad?
Yes.
I'm guessing you're holding restraint from playing it.
I keep losing at Triple Triad. And I don't want to waste time on the stream learning how to win a Triple Triad.
Also, one of you made a comment that people were trying to speedrun Sonic Adventure 2. I wish them luck on that.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to do so.
You wish
Knuckle
what?
Stages.
Oh, good luck. Oh.
Yeah, those Knuckle stages, basically.
Oh, withhold
whatever,
you good luck
the
for
radar
me because
thing.
It's the Knuckle stages that kill me when the Sonic stages don't. And the Tails stages don't.
The Knuckle
Which
stages
they usually
are,
do.
The Knuckle stages are RNG.
The Knuckle stages are
yeah,
the worst.
Basically
I
RNG.
I hate the treasure hunting stages, especially the Dry Lagoon. Especially, I hate that stage. Dry Lagoon is like my least favorite stage in a Sonic game. That's how hard it is for me. I don't like it. So I expect you to be present for at least the Sonic 2 race and maybe the Sonic 3 and Knuckles race, Dakota. Fish?
Fish Day.
What?
Capiche.
Okay. Capiche, capiche. Main discussion, we talk about literally anything other than food.
When I upload this one, it's probably going to be called Sonic Talking.
Sonic Talking?
Or maybe the sound of talking, I don't know. I'm going to try
talk
for
Sonic.
A Sonic cut.
Because of Sonic and Kirby and
Because we keep talking Sonic.
Sorry.
It's alright. It's better than not having anything to talk about at all.
Sonic. Yeah. Like you usually do.
I have something to relate to you. This is something that happened today.
Oh.
That guy I mentioned, the Isotronic guy, he not only has his own forums, he has his own Discord, and on the Discord, we have this bot that keeps track of our, that gives us XP for posts, but we only get XP once per minute.
Oh, yeah,
and
that's
today
in the...
basically shat itself.
Yeah, that's
essentially
the...
rolled back 2 weeks.
Oh my gosh.
Although most people gain levels or spice as we call it, since also fun fact, the ISO Discord is technically called a soup kitchen, and I'm technically a carrot on there. I hold the server role of carrot. So yeah,
well,
the bot
is getting more broken.
Basically back 2 weeks and people are really salty about it. And we can't get our ranks restored because they want us to actually fucking pay them money or some shit. I don't remember what Oat found out. Although Oat's actually a really cool person from what I've heard. Oat found that out and he was like, no, fuck that. And Chroma's
when,
in
the okay, so... For Sonic Heroes, for accessibility, the PC version will be allowed for the race. I cannot play Sonic Heroes because even though I have it, I, one, don't have a working Wii, and two, don't have a working GameCube controller that I can actually play with. Basically, it works, but it doesn't work. It's the reason I haven't even beaten Shadow the Hedgehog yet. Or played much of it.
Johnson was able to extricate himself. He went through the mountain passes.
Well, that was fortunate.
Richmond and Petersburg were like attacked.
Oh, great. Well, at least now we know where Ellen is.
What happened?
She's inside Lunatic Pandora.
Oh, joy.
Straight to the heart of the matter, disregarding the fact that I asked about everything else before asking about this.
Oh, hey, would you look at that? There's a new feature in Yandere Sim.
I don't have Yandere Sim, and I don't really care for it.
I'm interested in it solely for the amount of effort the developer's putting in.
Yeah, he's putting a lot of effort. It's kind of...
not
like,
and the email storms that he gets. You gotta feel bad for the guy.
Yeah, he's done quite a few things that say, do not fucking email me about stupid shit.
And yet...
and he keeps having to say it.
What? When he keeps getting emails, he keeps getting so many emails, that's ridiculous. I have to send him an email about asking him why this is happening. That's basically what it is.
I think he said there's very specific criteria to submit bug ports and stuff like that. Like, you need to be able to actually replicate the bug and tell him how to exactly do it. Like, if it's a one-freak-off thing, it's assumed you can ignore it. Although sometimes he can't even pull it off, and he'll say, oh, I can't pull this off. But Yandere Simulator is like one of those weird... it's like an anime mixed with Hitman. Although I've never played it, I've only seen things about it.
I'm gonna deafen myself while I listen to this.
Oh, it's just you and me.
Yep.
I'm guessing you went to go do something.
Well, 9:30 is about his limit. Dr. Odine, I don't think that plan's going to work, but we're on disk 3 of 4, so it probably will.
And it'll bring you to disk 4.
Well, I'm presuming disk 4 is going to be after I storm Lunatic Pandora and kill Sorceress Adele.
Wait, isn't...
isn't what?
I'm trying to compose my thoughts here, because sometimes I forget things in sentence.
Yeah, okay.
So, we're trying to stop a thing, but when stopping... God damn it, the button keeps deactivating after a few seconds.
The joys of push to talk.
I'm used to them. So after you do this sorceress lady, you're going to have to go after who again?
Okay, what I presume what we're going to do next is go to Lunatic Pandora and go kill Sorceress Adele before she can fully awaken. That will limit Ultimecia's targets to Renoa, who we have better control over. Once Ultimecia possesses Renoa, we use Eleni to send Renoa with Ultimecia back into the past so that Ultimecia can start the time compression. Please don't ask me why we're having her start the thing that's going to end the world.
Have you ever considered that this character is evil and we should not follow what they say?
Problem is that he's so far been the only one to come up with a plan that even sounds possible.
But triggering the end of the world will still possibly trigger the end of the world.
Well, here's the thing. He surmises that once Ultimecia starts the time compression, Eleni will be able to cut them off because they're using Eleni's power to go back in time in the first place. So even though the time compression will have been started, it won't finish. And we're supposed to ride the time wave up to Ultimecia's time.
This plan is sounding more and more impossible. It makes almost as much sense as the going in as robot forms in Earthbound. Oh, I forgot another spoiler. God damn it. I'm sorry if you've never played Earthbound.
I've not played it to completion, but I don't care about being spoiled about that one. Because I'm not playing... Because that's not one that I'm planning on playing blind for the stream.
I think it's the... You eventually do go back in time thanks to a time machine.
I know that robots.
That makes as much sense as that does, although it's actually kind of ingenious.
Can I get back to the stupid garden? Can I get back in garden, or is it forever stuck here at place? I think it's forever stuck here at this place. Great. But Lamp Garden is now forever marooned. I'm getting silly, and this is the very wrong direction. I'm just gonna park it here for now and call it a night. So thanks for stopping by.
Yeah. I actually didn't know you were streaming till like 8 o'clock. I thought you were gonna stream like an hour earlier.
No, I started 8.
I was waiting for you to start 7.
Well, I start the stream itself at 7:30, but I do pre-stream music. Because I have other setup stuff that I have to do before I can start the stream proper. But yeah, thanks for stopping by. And to the rest of you who are watching the VOD, see y'all next time. And remember, winners don't lose frogs.